K104, hip-hop and R&B, DD in the morning with Lady Jade and Michael Sean. I'm pretty excited. Today is a busy day. First of all, it is Lady Jade's birthday.
Happy birthday.
This one right here is going to be at the Arlington Improv. Y'all got to give it up for Monique and Tony.
Good morning.
Good morning,
unbelievable.
That I have an Academy Award winner
I
in
know
the
it.
Yeah. On my birthday.
On your birthday.
I know she came in just
okay.
for my birthday.
That's all I did. That's all I did, baby. I flew in last night for your birthday. Yeah,
that's exactly
okay,
that's what happened, Mom.
That's what I did. Now, damn it, I'm trying to get into the gate.
No, not into the gates, girl. I want to get to it. I'm like, can I get in?
It's going to take a lot of work, Didi.
I know it's going to take a lot of work.
I'm already in.
Oh, exactly. Good for you.
I'm celebrating it right now. I'm not waiting until I take them last breaths. I'm going to do my gates right now.
Oh, good for you.
I'm in heaven. Uh-huh. Feels like heaven.
Uh-huh. So Monique's going to be at the Arlington Improv, you guys, all weekend long. And so when she walked in, I'm going to tell you this right now. Monique walked in way smaller. I don't know what. Booty out there.
Looking good.
I mean, fabulous.
Amazing.
What do I say to that other than thank you, sis?
You know, and I'm going to be honest.
Thank you,
baby. Let me tell you something. I'm not blowing smoke up that nice round ass of yours.
Don't do it.
Okay, we're
don't
not doing
do
that.
Do it.
But the truth is, you really do look good.
You look
thank
great.
You,
baby.
You look amazing. And thank I got to apologize right now because I respect you so much, but I'm having lustful thoughts.
Listen.
I know it.
That's only natural. Especially when you see a woman, mm-hmm. a grown woman.
Talk
you know, DD.
Yeah.
I'm 48, mm-hmm. but I think I'm just coming into my woman.
Mm. Yeah.
I think I'm just coming to that place of finding that maturity, finding mm-hmm. that peaceful place. Like, I'm just getting to my woman.
And being comfortable mm-hmm. with who you
your
are.
Your walk mm-hmm. is different, baby. When you find that woman, yeah. your walk is
right.
different.
Your swag is
all
different.
Right.
Okay.
But Monique, here's my question. Because, you know, a lot of people will say when, like when Luther used to lose a lot of weight, people say it affects his singing, he ain't singing good. Or if somebody loses too much weight as a comedian or gets too pretty or attractive, they're not funny anymore. You're going to get up there and folks will be staring at your body. Are you nervous you're not going to be funny anymore?
No.
Okay.
No.
Oh, no, she said no.
I mean, no. I think that it only adds to it.
Okay.
Because
mm-hmm.
you're talking about life experiences. It's a challenge to try to lose 100 pounds and hold on to it.
Mm-hmm.
It's a challenge, baby, trying to try on bikinis. And some of them, they're still not right. Some of them still ain't working, baby. Okay.
Yeah.
I need the high waisted one.
Yeah.
Because
right.
that low waisted one, it don't work for me yet, DD. It's still hanging over.
This is the high waisted.
Come on. The high waist one.
But you know what? We've been watching. You know, when you walked in, I said, You going to come out with any kind of workout video or something? Because we see you on Instagram, on social media, everywhere. There's videos of you dancing,
girl. You're dancing every morning.
Sweating that
because
ass off.
Because it's fun.
I mean,
it's just a good time. Mm-hmm. And the young brother, Dwight Hole Jr., when I tell y'all, this little baby is so amazing, DD. I met him about 3 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
We were filming Bessie. He was staying where we were staying.
Mm-hmm.
He was in the gym dancing. I'm on the treadmill. Robin's on her treadmill.
Mm-hmm.
I said, Robin, that little boy challenging me.
Mm-hmm.
She said, Monique, that little boy don't know you. I said,
wait a minute.
He calling me over there.
Is he?
I went over there and danced with him that day.
That's what we do.
3 years.
That's what we do.
That was 3 years ago. Yes.
Right, hey, Jay, she does what we all do when we get into the workout and we in the gym. If somebody's on the treadmill next to you and you be like, what they going? What
you
speed
think
are
it's
they
a competition?
On?
Wait.
Don't let it be an older sister.
Okay.
Don't let her do it, baby. One about 75 on that treadmill and she up to about 6.5.
Yeah.
I'm like, you're not going
to
do that.
You'll kill yourself.
You're not
going to
do it.
Up, yeah?
Monique, please don't fall for these DD gym stories.
She used to walk it.
That's like me coming here with church stories. Okay.
Don't do it.
There ain't no damn gym stories
well,
that you got.
I went last week one time.
One time.
Tell her, because we always try to tell her. Every week we tell her to go to the gym.
How's your husband?
He's wonderful. Girl, he's wonderful. He's out of town this week and he went to a golf something. I don't know. He's good.
You got to stay in that gym to get it right. Keep it tight.
Oh,
and
man.
You know what?
Oh, wait a minute.
Talk to her. That's just to save your life.
I know it.
That's to save your life. It's just like, if you can't even get to that gym, put you on some music. Like I tell sisters, like, Monique, I can't afford the gym. Baby, put you on some music and shake your ass in your bedroom or your living room till you are out of breath and sweating. It works.
I'm going to tell you what I love about when you come in, because last time you were in, you told me and Lady J what we need to do in terms of, you said, don't go to bed with your man, because you're really strong about relationships. You believe in relationships.
Yes.
And you said to us, you know, like when we wearing our, I wear a scarf to bed. And you were like, uh-uh.
We told you about
then
that.
Then she said, take a shower before you get in bed. Take all that filth off of you. Don't get in the bed before you get in bed with your husband like that.
DD, have you started doing that?
Every now and then I'll take
listen
a shower.
Listen here.
She said every now and then.
This is my sister, Dirty
okay.
DD. Now,
Dirty
DD. Now,
Dirty DD.
I don't want to call you that, but if you don't start taking care of my brother-in-law.
I know it.
If you don't start taking care of that good man.
I know.
That's please laying speak next on to it. Your dirty ass and not complaining. But when y'all get about 30 years in, he's going to remind you when y'all about 80, you know you was a dirty ass. But you had a good heart. That's why I stayed with you.
Oh, my God. Yes. Okay, let me take a break, though, because we also need to talk more about relationships, because every time you come in, you know, everybody likes to ask these questions about you and that open relationship stuff and everything else, so we got to take a break. So I was just saying something about, before we get into relationships again, and everybody always wants to come at you about the, you know, open relationship. Have you been paying attention to, you know, the process that's going on, Trump and Hillary and everything else?
I have to tell you, I really have not.
Really?
Okay. Wow. Because I have children, baby.
Okay.
And I have a husband, so I'm not really focused on that. But what I did see last night... was Chelsea turn it over to her mama.
Right?
Beautiful.
Baby, listen here. I'm standing at the airport and I'm filling up because that was just a beautiful moment for that young lady to say, mama, you deserve this, baby. Go on and get it.
It messed us up because we all called our moms and I was like, mom, what... Like, her mama is going to be president. I was like, hey, mama, what's going on? What you been...
Because it makes you start saying, well, what you, mom, what you doing?
Yeah,
I mean,
like I said.
You thought your mom was the best mama, so you saw that last night.
No, our mamas are still the best mama.
I mean, our moms cook. We cook.
Our mamas cook.
I said, mom, you did cookies. She's going to run the country.
Our mamas nurture us differently, baby. Okay.
Well, look, as far as Trump goes... So I didn't get that.
Trump, you don't like him?
Listen. Y'all, listen. Stop playing. Because we didn't think he was going to get this far.
I know.
Yeah, man.
So, you know, when it's time to vote, make sure y'all go out there and make it happen. And vote for Barack, please.
Yeah. Vote for Barack.
Let's keep him. Let's keep him, baby.
Why if we, are you
listen,
playing?
Let's keep him. Because the day he and Michelle walk out that White House, oh, baby, I think the country, I think the world is going to take a deep breath. Because when they were in there and while they're there, they have been the absolute best family that has been in that White House because they did it with love.
Mm-hmm. Yes, they did.
They did it with love,
yes,
baby.
You want Barack again?
I want Barack. I want Barack forever.
I
want Barack to do like they do in other places. Listen, I'm not going nowhere.
Yeah. All he got to do is declare martial law. And
we'll
then he had to remain in office.
That's what I've heard about.
I've heard that. So, but I don't think they want the martial law part. But you could get him again if he
said
that.
Hey, Tone, if you're going to bring up martial law, set us up before you do that.
Right,
he's getting the hell out of me right now.
Not like it's getting ready to go on right now today.
Yeah. He's educating
us. But that's how you could do it, though. If you wanted to angle it in. That's all he had to
do. Have you guys, I mean, because you know, you do you're a celebrity and you've met a lot of people. Have you ever met Trump, by the way?
No.
Would you ever do that Celebrity Apprentice? Would you ever get on and do anything like that?
No. I don't do good with stuff. I don't do good with you fired.
Because
then it's like, who you talking to?
Right. Because
what
whole
I came up
scene.
With, baby, ain't nobody do what I did.
Scene, right?
Now you want to tell me I'm fired. Like, I don't do good with that. Like, Dancing with the Stars, I don't do good.
Yeah.
You going to judge my, give me
off.
Numbers. Are you out your damn mind? Did you see
four.
The kick I did?
Right.
Did you see the backflip I did? And you going to judge, baby, listen, I don't do good with it. I know my limits.
Okay, you guys, we are talking to comedian Monique, of course, going to be at the Arlington Improv. So let's talk relationships, for real. Let's talk about that. Do you feel like that statement that you made about having an open relationship and that your husband can go off and do this, do you feel like that has followed you now for years? Because you made that statement how long ago?
Well, here's what's beautiful, because as you tagged it with, your husband can go off and be with... And you tagged it with that as if that was what it was. Oh, Monique's husband can go do whatever he wants to do. That's not initially how it started.
How
it was my idea.
Oh,
it wasn't
ahead,
my husband's idea. But that was 11 years ago, and I was in a different place.
Yeah, okay.
And I was in that place of, I can do what I want. I can have what I want. I'm an entertainer. Don't you know how magic this is? I'm a celebrity.
Mm.
And being a celebrity, I can point and say, I want that. So I was in that place 11 years ago.
Yeah.
Now, are we still in an open marriage? Yes, we are.
Wow.
Could that take place? Could we sleep with other people? And is that a deal breaker? No, it's not.
Mm.
Because if you pay attention to relationships right now, what's the two things that separate them? Infidelity and finances. It's infidelity and finances. But if we have the real conversations and you're grown with it and you say to each other, listen, whatever feelings I'm having, I want to be able to share them with you because this is a lifetime.
Yeah.
So then are you
Look
saying
at Michael
when,
Sean.
When you have those grown conversations and you express, okay, this is how I'm feeling, normally you guys fulfill that for each other so you don't have to step out of the relationship? Or
here's what's beautiful. All these people on the earth,
mm-hmm.
are you only attracted to your ex-husband?
No.
Was he the only man that you were attracted to? Do you think you were the only woman he was attracted to?
Not at all.
So what we're saying is, as grown people, if that should happen, that's not a deal breaker. And it has nothing to do with what I'm giving my husband. It has nothing to do with that. People, well, you're not fulfilling him. Is he not fulfilling you? It has nothing to do with that. It's just life. Mm. And if things happen, we're not willing to say we're going to break up our family. Mm-hmm. We're going to now go through all of this after all we've been through because you had sex with somebody.
What?
We're not willing
to do that.
There's only one Monique in the world. No. She's taking, baby.
Understand, we just think on a different level. I've been in an open relationship my entire life. The other person just didn't know.
That's all it is. I think we're too afraid just to have the honest conversations because we've been conditioned to have ownership.
Yeah, because the truth is, women will forgive, right? I mean, they'll find
people
out their
men. People will forgive.
Yeah, look at Hillary and Bill yesterday. So did they not get through that?
Did you think that Hillary was going to say, I'm going to walk away from this man since we've been in college together because this sister gave him some extra treatment? He's the president. And she couldn't come out and just say that. But it's like, y'all, if it was my husband, I would have did the press conference and said, ladies and gentlemen, could the sister please come up here to do that? I want to thank you. Because you keep it peaceful. I want to thank you. We don't even have to go through all this. Your husband's the president. Yeah, the president.
Some of these females don't have that option. Like, you keep it together, your husband the president. Now, if your husband is the president at Family Dollar. It's different to hold it together.
He's still the president, baby.
He's still the president.
He's still the president. Right. He's still holding it down.
So if he's a president, he gets a pass.
Yeah, if he's a comedian, he gets a pass, damn it.
Here's the thing.
Really?
We're just people. And if we stop judging each other so harshly, we would all just get a pass. Yeah. Because if you look right now and you say, one year, and it was done.
Oh, absolutely. Mm-hmm.
1 year. Mm-hmm. And because we're not willing to have those real conversations to say, listen here, hook or crook, hell or high water, we in this.
I know that's right.
So whatever it's going to be, it's going to be. Because when you talk to those older sisters that's been in it over 50 years,
Come on.
You say, mama, did he ever get with somebody else? She say, girl, listen here, all the somebodies he had and all the somebodies I had, we always came back to each other. Mm-hmm. That's what it was.
Right.
And that's coming from sisters in the nursing homes. That's 80, 90 years old. It's just real conversation.
It's real. Wow.
And it ain't for everybody.
Nope.
It ain't for everybody.
Look at Michael Sean. He's loving it.
Miss Monique, is there any way I can put you on speakerphone? And you can talk to somebody for me?
She listening right now.
Yes, she is.
And I'm going to tell you something. Not only are you in an open relationship, so is she. Y'all just ain't had the conversation yet.
Don't tell him that. You ain't know about that part, right? He didn't read the instruction manual.
As long as we don't know.
Okay, there it is.
Why don't you know? Let that be your best friend for real, baby.
Let the who be the best friend.
Let your woman be your best friend.
Oh, yes, exactly.
Real.
Michael Sean doesn't even like other men liking his girl's pictures on Instagram.
Wait a minute.
That's when it's called unfair. You're in a selfish open relationship.
And tell an ex, yes, it is a selfish relationship.
That's selfish.
Oh, my God.
Look, I'm a work in progress.
Yes, he is.
Aren't we all?